Hello everyone, and welcome to the LPFWA episode that pretty much is me being a lazy piece of shit, and I only play the Undertale soundtrack in the background this entire time, because
It fills us with determination.
It does indeed. And apparently people decided that they want to see LPFWA fighting Ric Flair next. But nobody called me out on forgetting to add the Ultimate Warrior to, you know, the poll, but that's your fault, not mine. So, I guess we'll just start now without any further ado.
Yeah, let's do it.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be amazing. And I can already tell that my capture card just is like 10,000 seconds behind, because only now do we get the chance to reveal the real loading screens that were hiding behind the fake loading screens.
Whoa!
It's always funny. Never stops being funny. So yeah, enjoy these loading screens while this music is way too loud.
Just a little bit.
Don't worry, it's gonna fix itself in a couple seconds. I just need to, in the middle of the show, start applying replay gain to all the tracks. It's just gonna take a few more seconds. And from the looks of it, Palpatine is trying to hold a speech or something in the middle of the ring, because that's just the kind of guy he is.
Fitting.
It is perfect, yes. More perfect than you'd know. Oh, yes. So, Palpatine apparently thinks that he actually did beat The Undertaker. It's just that I will not acknowledge it, even if it happened. But that's just, you know, something you already know.
Yeah.
Sad it ended so soon. Like, the Undertaker streak was just one win.
That's not a streak.
Yes, that's not a streak. Exactly. The real streak was 21 wins over 21 years. And look at that, the hero of the day appears. Like, you can't see it yet.
Yeah.
Because the capture card is like 10 hours behind. But you'll say it in like 10 hours.
There,
the best guy ever, he's here.
the best guy.
Yeah, man. His shirt says that he's the boss. Your boss, to be specific. Because, you know, I actually am everybody's boss in LPFWA, because I can just change anything to my whim. Like, not at a second's notice, of course, but I can. But yeah, as announced, Iggy was on vacation and now he's back. Because of reasons, because apparently he can't go on vacation forever. I'd like to, but I can't. Of course, his excuse is being set on fire, that doesn't count. And 2 weeks aren't exactly an extended vacation either.
Well, it's nice rest.
It's 1 week? No, it's some amount of time, let's go with that. And this is really confusing because I keep having to go back and forth just to make sure that I don't comment on anything that hasn't happened yet, because it's really about 30 seconds.
My goodness, that's a lot. That's gonna be tough in matches.
Oh, it's no problem in matches. Because in matches, I will not have to look at my TV to advance the text.
I suppose.
I'll just look at the actual capture card footage that comes in. Of course, Pyro, you're gonna destroy Palpy. Everyone's gonna destroy Palpy. He just thinks he's good now because he beat the Undertaker. I mean, he never did that, but he thinks he's good because he believes he beat the Undertaker. Which he clearly didn't. Just in case there was any confusion. Because the Undertaker's better than him. Boy, it's really I need to measure that time because it's way too long. I hope Sims Magic evens it out later again. yeah, he kind of already did skip something just now, but it's still not quite caught up because on my end, Pyro is already in the ring. Okay, he's in the ring, he's standing on the apron, but now he's in the ring. So maybe it's not 30 seconds, but it's at least 10. And now it's loading the next entrance. And that will be a debut that I held off for a long time because the guy didn't come back to me with new music, but I don't care anymore. I just picked music for him.
Yeah.
It's not a Kanye song though. Just imagine there's a Kanye song here.
Okay.
But this isn't
one. I've not heard any of them, so that'll be hard, but I'll try.
It's okay. Just imagine the one that's here that's not a Kanye song, but it's... Yeah. It's funny, at least. Jesus invented Krunk, that's great. funny story, I know this song because I watched Axial's Let's Play of Super Metroid Redesign. It's quite a bad Let's Play in that sense. No offense to Axial, but... in the last episode, he just kind of goes on a swearing spree because he's very angry. Then somebody plays the song through their speakers and he starts laughing. And I can understand why. So yeah, this is now Jesus' song, even though I'm pretty sure it's not fitting.
He looks a lot like Cyrek in the face area.
Well, I don't know, maybe Sabatini, who made Cyrek back in the day, just used that same face template, I don't know. Look at that Undertale battle music in the background.
Yeah.
That's fitting. Because I'm just going through a soundtrack because I'm lazy and it'll not always make sense. Yes, Undertale is indeed good, thanks for noticing. Which is why I'm playing the soundtrack today. I'm glad we all agree, we're all good friends, we can look each other in the eye. And wow, that's a panty shot! Yeah, that was great. I'm glad I made his underwear white. So I can't believe I say this, but I'm rooting for Zor. Actually, I can't believe I say this because I'm always rooting for Zor. Because Zor is the hero that we deserve. As opposed to that guy. Yeah, I didn't really do a good job of recreating Kanye West's face because I don't want to fiddle with this game's character creation more than I need to.
I think this is probably my favorite song on the soundtrack.
It's a great song, yes. There's another version too, which is
Yeah.
more extended. It's also one of the best characters. And I don't want to make this the Undertale chat, but if you actually attack Napsa Luke in his first appearance, he'll just mock you. He'll tell you that that he just pretended to lose HP to be nice. And then you lose experience.
Whoa, really?
Yep. And okay, this is the beginning of this. I don't want to spoil it anymore in case some people haven't played it yet, because yeah, it's a great game and you should probably play it. Oh wow, Jesus is kind of a dick. He stomped Sora and then showed him the middle finger. Now I'm definitely rooting for Sora. Never mind. Of course Sora lost. Whoa, that crowd is damn loud. I'll just have to change Sora's moveset at some point, because I can't explain any other way.
Yeah.
He will turn from the biggest jobber to our number one. I can already see it. It's gonna be the number one success story ever, because, yeah, reasons.
I'm trying to think of an LBFWA that involves Undertale. Like an acronym, but it's there's no U. It's like, ugh.
Well, you can incorporate Undertale in the show that you're gonna make.
Yeah.
I mean, you can try. I don't know what plans you have, but
that's a secret.
Okay, I'm gonna accept that.
I mean, obviously, you'll be the first to know, but...
Yeah, because I have to actually make
it. For now, it's a secret.
Yeah. It should, of course, obviously be a secret here on air to avoid spoilers for the unsuspecting audiences, because they just really, you know, need to be caught off guard by the amazing stuff that's gonna happen.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Eclectic Tastes wants to start a feud again, but, you know... I'm not really, really going along with it, because I'm a dick. You know, Iggy, aka me, is not, like, he doesn't seem drunk, at least compared to the other times that we've seen him. A.K.A. me. At the very least, he seems to be aware of the situation, and he seems to be willing to deal with it, which is very unlike me, A.K.A. Iggy, which is me, A.K.A. Iggy. And I already said it, but they made the show this morning, and I didn't proofread it, and you can tell because some of the line breaks don't really work.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, Craig Chase is just really, 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 really mean to me. Yes, he hasn't even seen my true form yet.
True form?
Yeah.
Do you just change your shirt or something?
I lose my pants, that's all.
Oh, I see.
respected taste also has its true form. I wonder what that is.
Oh. Oh boy.
So yeah, next week, this is gonna be biggest match ever. Collected Taste versus me, both of us using our true forms.
Oh yeah.
It's gonna be amazing.
Sure, whatever.
You know, I advanced that text box like 10 seconds ago. Okay, I know Frieza is some Dragon Ball dude, but I never really watched Dragon Ball.
I don't know.
I like to pretend it's because I have taste, but then again, I kinda don't. Oh, Pyro, you think this is a moon? It's a moon. So, what match? Oh yeah, this is the match where Jamie shows up. And he's of course up against our number one. Didn't we have this match already? Making his way to the ring. Representing the good girls. Jamie, I think you have won a match. But I don't know for sure. I'd have to check, and I don't want to check.
So what's up with representing the good girls?
It's the game glitching out. The good girls is the anime stable, actually. But the game just pretends that random people aren't stable sometimes.
Okay.
And sometimes they come out to the wrong entrance because of that, which is hilarious, because at some point the least anime people came out to the anime stable entrance.
Wasn't it Ansel and Galen?
Yeah. Actually, it's pretty anime. Yeah, because Star Wars is fucking anime. No matter what you say. Jamie is up against the legendary chopper Skier.
Oh yeah.
And as always, Skier is just really damn pumped to be here. And he even has a Twitter. I don't even know why the game allows you to enter a fucking Twitter account, because, yeah. Yeah, just, I don't know. I kind of allow people to add their Twitter accounts, mainly as a joke. I didn't expect anyone to do it, but people did it.
I did it.
Yes, I did too. I think actually Jamie did as well. Maybe. Probably.
I don't know. I don't.
I didn't actually look at his nameplate.
Yeah.
Nobody will die. They'll both lose. Yeah, actually this is battle music. This is fitting, because this is obviously a fight those people are having. Look, they're punching and kicking. Oh boy, what a suplex! I like saying that. Another suplex. Eventually, Aurora will have to come and just complain about everybody. There's another suplex! Okay, I'm gonna count now. Those are three suplexes from Jamie. Because normally it's Aurora doing plenty of suplexes. For obvious reasons, because her finish was basically nine suplexes in a row. I'd like to say this is an even fight, but it seems like Shane is actually dominating here. And that was the fourth suplex.
Mm-hmm. This is a pretty good song.
Yes, it is, of course, the theme of the best character.
I'm not sure if I agree it's the best character.
It's a good character, okay?
It's a very, very good character.
That was suplex from Skier, holy shit. Now Skier's starting to actually do stuff. Never mind. Five.
Well, there we go.
I should have seen it coming. I will laugh if Skier just kind of wins. Because, certainly doesn't look like it. This is also a theme of a pretty good character.
Yeah.
I can tell right now, we're gonna talk more about Undertale and its soundtrack than LPFWA.
Nothing wrong with that. Like, maybe. I guess that depends on who you are.
Well, let's just say I don't want to spell Undertale for people who watch this.
Yeah.
Listening to the music can't hurt anybody.
Yeah, it's very nice.
This is fitting battle music.
Oh yeah, Snowden is really aggressive.
It is. So I didn't look for a second. Did Jamie do another suplex?
I wasn't looking either.
I'm just gonna assume that he didn't, because that's gonna make it easier to count. What's he? No. This move does zero damage, you idiot! Yeah, look, he gets up right away. Oh, man. But sure, whatever. It was his choice to do the move. So it's obviously his fault for, you know, not doing any damage with it. Oh, look at that! Jamie's calling him the bad guy. I'm pretty sure Skier's is Sunshine. Unless
yeah, I think
isn't.
So.
It used to be Sunshine in the old LPFWA. Okay, now Skier actually does stuff. Oh, here comes his finisher. The chop. Let's just call it the chop. Yeah, that's a good name for a finisher.
Oh, that was a close one.
Yeah. Skier's the best chopper after all. He always drives to get a close match. Just received a rather mysterious contact request on Skype. I'm not sure what's up with
what's
that.
Say?
I'm just gonna. Hey, oops. This is the wrong thing to do. I'm just gonna add him to the commentary group. Oh, this is the commentary group.
Oh boy.
Group. Oops, this is the wrong chat. Add him to the wrong chat. I'm a dumb idiot for idiots. I suck.
Oh, no.
I added to the LPF chat. This is probably a mistake. Where the fuck is the commentary group gone?
Music fits this situation.
It does. Holy shit. Where is the group? I can't find
Biggie
it!
Biggie is getting dunked on, everybody.
Holy shit! Where is it? Crap! Fuck! This is confusing to me, really. Seriously. Oh yeah, there. I think I did it. Okay, I did it though.
Blue.
I like that one song started playing right as it was just, you know, doing dumb shit. Oh, and look at that! Spear put on a show.
Here is your winner, representing the good girls, the Dreamer of Sin. He gets
a the Dreamer of Sin. This is such a great name.
That was an incredible match. Tremendous performances put on tonight. Thanks for joining us, ladies and gentlemen.
So, Jamie, if you didn't win a match before, now you did. But I think you won before.
Oh boy. Who's up next?
I could look. Oh, right, I need to record the match results.
Yeah.
I forget that every week, and then I have to catch up in the middle of the show. Oh yeah, music. For as long as the loading screen lasts, at least, and then the entrance will start again. And then we'll see who actually, you know, is wrestling. It's gonna be Fruits of Friend Frosty, but not in that order. Because first off, it's Frosty coming in. Making his way to the ring. So obviously the first match was won by Not-Zor.
Not-Zor? Oh, we got a new wrestler?
Yeah, no.
Oh, actually we did, but...
We do, yes. And then Jamie the D1. By pinfall, I'm gonna assume. If not, I don't care.
I think it was pinfall.
It's pinfall. Somebody in the chat is gonna correct me or confirm. And if they do or don't, I don't care. I'm just gonna pretend it was pinfall. No, I won't. I just wanna get things right, kind of. Oh, no. Here comes one of my favorites, Fruit Sniffer.
Fruit Sniffer's a fan.
Why isn't Fruit Sniffer here right now? What a dick.
I don't know. He hates fun.
Yeah. I remember when he always camped in my hitbox channel, but now he doesn't anymore. Probably because he forgot. Well, of course you... Only 3 copies, though?
Huh?
Like, Jamie said that, even villains like him have 3 copies of all Fruit Sniffer albums.
Yeah, why only 3?
Yeah, I mean... I have a whole box full of them. Okay, that explains it. He did say Willen. And it appears that Pyroy is now in the channel with us. I hope you can hear us.
Let's get ready to wrestle.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
So,
coal miners.
Yes, they say that it's just with every match's beginning. I don't know why. It's probably got some reason, but I don't know why. It seems awfully specific.
A little bit.
Well, you see, coal miners are the main population on the moon.
Okay, I'm no scientist.
Is there
and
a lot
don't
of
know,
coal on the moon?
I don't know much about moon, but I was about to ask, yeah. Is there actually coal on the moon? I kind of doubt it.
The moon is actually a giant ball of oil.
So it's not really mining, it's more like just like picking it up from the ground and just dumping it in a like a wheelbarrow.
Yes, yes.
Oh. Wait. But okay, coal can't exist on the moon, right?
Why not?
Okay, I am not sure. I'm just gonna wait for somebody who actually knows stuff to back me up. Which is probably not gonna happen ever.
No, it's not. It's not.
Somebody commented on there being three chopper matches, but you know, Frosty isn't a chopper. He's the opposite of a chopper.
Yeah, just look at how he's absolutely destroying Fruit Snipper.
Yes, and Fruit Snipper, you know, he used to be a chopper, but he isn't anymore. So technically, this isn't a chopper match. Except one of those guys will have to chop to the other. But let's not put it that way, that's gonna make it less exciting. Let's just say this is a really exciting fight between two strong people who are just, you know, duking it out right now. And eventually, one of them will not be able to get up anymore. Hey, look at that! Those are some five moves of
doom. Oh my god!
Okay, I don't recognize that.
That's his comeback. That was a reverse hawk, holy crap. I think that was a signature move actually, I'm not sure though. Oh, now he's hugging him, holy crap, this could be it.
My god.
Nah. Don't think he's gonna tap though, because yeah. If they tap, they're usually a little bit quicker. Okay, I think now Frosty is starting to stop fucking around. Yeah, it was a finisher, that's called the Dragon Buster. For some reason, Frosty decided that his finisher should be a custom one. Even though that means
first
that...
First he breathes bad breath on his enemy.
Yeah, exactly. And it means he's probably gonna lose because custom finishers don't do very much damage compared to regular finishers. Unless, of course, he's still gonna win. Like Aurora always does. Except when she fights evil. And this fight continues to move on to some dating music in the background.
Dating music is the official music of all wrestling.
Yeah. If you think about it, a wrestling match is
just
basically a date.
Gallon and Dash.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Like, But it actually is kind of like a date. Only they're not trying to get into each other's pants or anything. They're just trying to get on top of each other and then lift up one of their legs and make sure they stay on. No, this is going the wrong way. But anyway, pinfall, that's what I was going for. Frosty just pinned Rudy. I miss old Frosty though.
Wasn't he the pizza golem?
He was, in fact, the pizza golem, yes. But then he showered.
Yeah, this is he's down away from that.
Yeah. I mean, he could turn into pizza again, but he's somehow against that. I don't know why.
Is he?
Yeah. I mean, he doesn't want to be a pizza anymore. He wants to be remembered as... I didn't know what he wants to be remembered as. I don't know. I have no idea.
Put a pizza on his shirt.
There's an idea. I'll just do it without telling him. I don't even know if he's still watching. He'll probably never notice. I can do what I want! Yes.
This music is like just fitting that so well.
Of course it is. Oh, you're right. Next up, we have Evil representing all the women of LPFWA. Because of reasons. Because, you know, sometimes stuff needs to happen. Like this time when Palpatine just refuses to let women wrestle.
Yep, all Palpatine's fault.
It is his fault, actually. I'm gonna pretend it's his fault. It's not because we don't have any female talent or anything. Except for, like, 6 people.
Yeah, no, that'd just be ridiculous.
Yeah. But more people will probably show up.
Maybe. Someday.
Soon. I made one of them. Kind of. But anyway, look.
Did you?
Yeah. I made the one that you wanted the most, probably.
Perfect.
And I'm gonna make more, of course, because it would suck if I didn't.
Yeah, because then we'd only have 7 women wrestlers instead of 6.
We might have 8, or 9, or even 10.
My god.
Hey, this is gonna be amazing. I hope. But yeah, look at Emperor Palpatine, who's about to generate some cheap heat, probably, because that's just the kind of guy he is. Any second now. Just you wait. Oh yeah, there it is. Look, he's being kind of misogynist. That's JP. It's easy to hate him. Yeah. That's totally a good villain.
Man, I can't wait until I beat him up later today.
I can't wait until everybody beats him up later today, and he thinks he's gonna win just because he's beat the Undertaker, or pretends he beat the Undertaker, because he never beat the Undertaker. The Undertaker's invincible.
Hey, it's Divine Coffee Bitch.
Oh yeah. Well, that's not what you call payment, that's what you call a bribe. So who's up next anyway? That's a
some
sweet
people.
Song. That's a sweet song.
Wrestle People Men?
Like that one.
Yeah, pretty much.
But yeah, it's gonna be...
Face versus Immortan Joe.
Yes, I was about to say, because I have the match card in front of me now. Not before, though.
Oh boy.
And here comes Face to some German rap I can't make out the lyrics of. Because it's hard to understand German rap lyrics when the audio quality is so low. But you know, it doesn't matter anyway. What does matter is that this is a totally hot match. Because it's somebody from the Order under Palpatine's orders against somebody who has a friend who was killed by Palpatine.
Yes.
Yeah. I think we had this match already, I'm not sure. Maybe we didn't though. Maybe I was too lazy to check. Maybe I just don't remember that we may have had this match already. Maybe I wasn't the one who booked it, maybe it was Palpatine. It was Palpatine's fault if it's, that way, yeah. And yeah, the last relic of the Hattitude era is now wearing a gas mask instead of a fedora.
Truly a great loss for all of wrestling history.
Well, the Hattitude era was pretty good, actually, except for all the fedoras. It had some of the best matches of LPFWA history, which we're never gonna see because I deleted the archives and no one's gonna see it ever. And in case you don't remember from last time Immortan Joe had a singles entrance, this is water, not like soda or an energy drink or anything. It's water. And of course he comes in like the true leader that he is. Wielding a sword, or rather a kendo stick.
Big booming music coming up behind him.
I don't want to say this, but I'm glad Lazy Fire died, because that will get to see Cho's entrance. By the way, Lazy Fire isn't actually dead, like the real person, just in case you may have thought that.
What?
The actual form post of Lazy Fire is still alive, it's just that the character Lazy Fire is dead.
What the fuck? I thought this was real life.
Yeah, it's real life, especially since Lazy Fire was in chat after he died. But yeah. He even was on commentary after he died. Then again, he also returned as a ghost last time. But yeah, for obvious reasons, I do hope that Cho wins this time. Because I do want to root for the faces here. It's kind of funny that Cho is the face here, and Face is the heel. Not just because Face is called Face, but because Cho is a villain. But that's how things go sometimes. Oh yeah, of course.
Wicked good music.
Oh yeah. Just to adjust the audio levels a little bit. There. Should be slightly better now.
If you have not played Undertale, go fix this.
Yes, do it. I mean, we keep saying this like it means something, but it does mean something. Because it's literally just 10 bucks and you are probably a member of the 10 forum you paid 10 bucks for. So I'm pretty sure you have 10 bucks to spare.
And hey, the pay-per-view.
Oh yeah, next week. The pay-per-view, which isn't related to Undertale. It's gonna happen though. But yeah, we have, for some reason, 4 guitars under the ring, but no one's gonna pick them up.
Well, they don't have time for a rock solo, so there's really no point.
Oh yeah, by the way, the poll, showed that people want us to fight Ric Flair next, but who is actually gonna fight him first?
The champion.
Champion, Flamander.
I don't know.
We kind of Flamander fight, fight Ric Flair. Because Ric Flair is like the 14-time world champion or something. Maybe it was more in the end, I'm not sure. Maybe won the title a couple more times, but he has quite a resume. Mostly of yelling woo and falling over or doing his signature flop. Oh yes, he's... Joe was about to pull out a guitar from under the ring, but... Faze interrupted him. I think we have our episode title now. Or rather, our LBFWA acronym. Look, punk, Flair's woos are awesome. Because they are. I just wish that Flair's Wu-Tang in this game had actually had him, you know, go woo! But I don't think so.
Okay, here's what's happening. Morton Joe from Mad Max Fury Road is fighting Face from LPFWA while really spooky music plays.
Yes, it's gonna get spookier now.
Ooh.
The next song's gonna be even spookier, just so you know. This should have been the week before last week when we actually had a show that was Halloween themed. Because, you
know, he grabbed the guitar.
I kind of want them to actually use the guitar though. To play music, not to hit each other. This is a peaceful promotion. Don't know why they're hitting each other.
The person who wins has to win at a game of dueling banjos.
Yes, that. Oh my god, Cho tapped. What the hell?
God damn it, Joe.
I call shenanigans. Oh yes. I guess that happens.
Truly, this is the darkest hour.
Yes, Benjamin's show is the guy who actually won a handicap match for the title. So this is like super sad. Next week, Cho will actually have to defend the title, though. Again. Don't know who he's gonna partner up with, like, this time. Probably Loki again. Because Lazy Fire's ghost can't, you know, touch things because he's a ghost. And... wait, next up, we actually... Oh, right. I remember now. I remember what's up next. Up next, after the scene that's gonna happen, we're gonna have a little bit of a disc change. Because of reasons. The usual reasons, of course. Alright, look there, who's preying on potential interruption targets. And I'd like to comment, but... Oh yeah, right there, yes, yes, see? I didn't forget, annihilated. Who is in the chat right now? That you won a Flaming Tables match with Junpei for some reason. You can't see me right now, but I'm smiling because of the music.
Real talk for a second?
Sure.
Temmie, best character or bestest character?
Best enemy. Well, enemy. But not really enemy. I think when Temmie appears, it says special enemy here to defeat you. I like that. And then Temmie, of course, doesn't do anything. But
you can get the Tem armor from her.
Yes, you can also get Temmie flakes from them if you buy them. You can buy them from the Tem shop for various amounts of currency, and they all do the same thing. It's the best thing. I love Undertale, I'm just gonna say that right here.
Interruption is a fine art. If you do it too soon, then it's not worth it. Too late, same thing.
Yeah. But yeah, actually the reason we're playing Undertale music today is because before the show, I was showing off Flamander's champion theme to Rara, but then we somehow got the bright idea to just use the Undertale soundtrack for LPFWA. And speaking of the devil, this is Flamander's champion theme.
There it is!
Yeah. I didn't know this was gonna come up, by the way, it's just coincidence. I don't have the entire playlist memorized. Because it's about 100 songs. 101 songs even.
And they're all good.
Yes, they're all good. And that song's especially good, compared to some others. Oh, that isn't actually the song for Flamander. And you can see the bare skeleton of LPFWA here. I'm gonna remove that for 1 second. So yeah, next up we're gonna have a little bit of a tag match, where members of the Aura 66 fight against the members of the Auranime and the Auradical.
Whoa!
It's amazing, I know.
I just need to
set up the match. It's gonna be a tornado tag match, I have decided. It's a bit of a shame though that this music plays over the loading screens and not over the actual fight. And this is Flamander's new theme. Okay. Just a second. I'm doing things here. So it is...
Congratulations.
Yes. It is Atzel McFluffybottom. Versus... Oh, no, not versus. Together with Interrupted Jones. Where the hell's Atzel? Oh, there he is.
My goodness.
I found him. I mean, of course, you can't see it in the chat, but I'm actually picturing the match right now. I'm pretty sure you can tell it's an amazing thing. Behind, who will of course come in with both of his titles, because that's just the kind of guy he is. And the great taste is not coming with any title because Chumpy took it from him last week. What a dick. I mean, what a great guy. No. Coffee Pinch, that's not the kind of guy I am. Yet. I mean, eventually I will of course have to turn to the dark side.
First, so that I become champion.
I'll make myself a champion. Don't worry. If you win, I am just gonna come and I'm a heel. I can't do that. So yeah, if you win, you get a title shot. That's how it works. But not this match, next match. Match after that. That's what next means. I love that music, it's dumb. I love it. I don't know why I love it so much. Look at that
music.
It's... yes, because. It's a good as reason as any. Hey, they don't even... okay. I didn't turn entrances off, but whatever.
Whoops.
I'm not gonna take it.
Entrances are for losers.
Oh, whatever. So this is our next to last match. Kind of. Oh, never mind. We're gonna have two more matches after this because we also have to have Ric Flair fight somebody. For some reason. We don't know why and we don't need a reason either.
Well, the Undertaker just suddenly stopped appearing, so we need someone to fight.
Well, we don't know why we have people fight the Undertaker either. And it's not like we need a reason for that. Same thing for John Cena. We don't need a reason for people fighting John Cena either. Just kind of, you know, happens.
Really, no one here has a reason to fight anyone except for Palpatine. We should all team up on Palpatine.
Well, everyone has a reason to fight Palpatine. So, yeah. And the people who work for Palpatine have a reason for fighting, you know, against the people who are fighting against Palpatine. For reasons that are hopefully obvious. And look at the Eclectic Tastes already putting on their radical moves. I could swear I turned down the crowd noise so I could hear the music better, but I guess I need to test it again, because that's also pretty sweet music. What the hell? Okay, now. See, this is how things work. I fixed things on the fly. It's very confusing. But it works now. And we get to hear the Undertale soundtrack. And Chunpei is performing his finisher, the Kawile Driver, against Axel.
It's too kawaii.
Oh boy.
Well, since Jones was busy outside of the ring, that could have been it.
Could have.
But it wasn't.
Yeah. And Hurricane Rana now. From the fucking top rope. Chunpei means business. I can tell. And the cameras...
Yeah, the way that he has his head on the ring. Yeah. That's definitely a way to show that he means business.
Yeah, the camera's almost zoomed out too much, too, to actually make out stuff, but it's working. I like that both of them actually picked an opponent and stick with them. Oh shit, the spin interruption. I don't know why it's called the spin interruption, but it certainly is a move that spins. It probably interrupted something.
It interrupts their life.
This isn't the Halloween episode, man.
You can still be spooky.
Alright, we can't spooky anytime. Because mainly because this
you
is
you can be spooky all year long.
Oh yeah. This is now not humorous anymore, it's just a horror LP.
Yeah.
It's gonna get really creepy from here on out. It's just that you won't notice. It's that kind of creepy. Shinpei's actually doing the big moves here.
He really doesn't like Interrupter Jones.
Well, he used to beat up Atzel until they somehow switched opponents. What the fuck? It looked for a second like Shinpei was gonna do a power bomb on Jones. Weird and amazing with Jones is like thrice as big as Shinpei. And that was almost it.
And they've swapped opponents again.
Yeah, sure. Why not? They can do that. And they really want to pin Atzel.
It's not gonna happen.
Who knows? Maybe it is.
I mean, yeah, probably it's gonna happen. But whatever.
It is gonna happen. Okay, maybe it's also gonna be Jones, or... Honestly, it kind of looks like, Chunpei and Tastes are winning right now. Which is kind of surprising, because Jones actually is a pretty strong opponent. But he just got pinned. There goes. And... You wanna talk about incredible... Wow! It increased the volume again. That's not me, it's just randomly happening. It's not my fault.
Are you sure?
Kind of. If it's my fault, I don't know how it is. Because I'm not doing anything. Yes, DCB, it's my fault. Everything that happens in LBFWA is my fault. Even Palpatine is my fault. Even Standgate is my fault. Because even though I can't do anything about it, Standgate happened and it's my fault. Yeah. Look at them being all cooperative and shit. Even though they fought each other last week for a title. Divine Coffee Binge, do you also blame me for, World War II? Because I'm pretty sure that was another German. No, it was an Austrian even. It wasn't me. That's what I'm saying. I wasn't responsible for World War II, because World War II is, horrible. For multiple reasons. Mainly because of genocide and all that stuff, but... Oh yeah, right! I was about to say, no, this isn't really the kind of subject matter that you want to see in LBFWA, but we did say it's going to be more spooky. Yeah.
Yeah, it's all par for the course.
Yeah. So, the Holocaust is a thing that happened? And it's really dark,
right,
and this is, like, spooky, so... Yeah, let's not go further, because... of reasons. We're not gonna have a cage match.
Spoilers, I win.
Maybe. We don't know yet. It's all on the stars at this point. You might win though, because last show was pretty amazing, that ladder match. It was... Maybe the best match we had yet. Possibly. Could be the best match. But that's up to the people who actually watched the match. I mean, I watched it too, but I'm not the only one with an opinion. So who's in this match anyway, except for Pyro?
Palpin.
Sans Abraham is.
And Frederick Hope.
I'm just gonna... I'm gonna just put him in the order that I have him on the match card. So Sans Abraham versus Pyro. It's very hard to actually select people from the character select. Versus Frederick Hope. Because, you know, he kind of deserves a rematch. Who knows if Lamander was just lucky? I mean, he might not have been, but we don't know. He at least deserves a shot at the rematch. I skipped past him. I don't know why I say this, because the chat can't see it, obviously, but... I'm doing it anyway. And Emperor Palpatine. If Palpatine wins, I'm gonna flip my shit. I'm just gonna say that right now.
Just a cleric on canon.
It's not gonna happen.
If it happens, I'm gonna pretend it's not canon, but it's obviously gonna be, like with the Undertaker losing against Palpatine. So yeah, this is a cage match. Cage matches might last for a while, or they might just end after a couple seconds, depending on how it goes. Much like ladder matches. If they're good, they're really good.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Let's get ready, oh yeah, indeed. Let's just hope that the entrances don't bug out again.
And then everyone is punchy.
Look, it's a caveman coming into electronic music. He's proven to be a surprisingly good wrestler compared to Mihujael, who had the exact same moveset and the exact same physical build and face. I don't know.
He's not wearing a shirt.
Yeah, he's not wearing a shirt. He's also not wearing whatever Mihujael wore. Because this is not Mihujael, this is Sans Abraham. Clearly a different person, not the same guy.
Now your future champion.
Oh. Let's hope you're not talking out of your ass. Let's hope that this is actually true. Well, honestly, I don't care who wins this match, as long as it's not Palpatine. Because, if it's Palpatine, I'll have to just really, really, really insist that it's not canon, even though it officially happened. And I have to say, I really like that metal version of Kirby music.
It's really good.
And now we have someone else with pretty cool music coming in. Our former champion and champion of the people, Frederick Hope. I say champion of the people, obviously, I don't know that, I just say it. It's kind of weird seeing him come in without the belt, though. Because he won the championship belt pretty early on. A few weeks after he showed up and won every match. But, you know, the truth
well,
is that
he... Well, let's see if he can earn it back.
Yeah. Well, the truth is he doesn't actually care about the title. He just wants to wrestle. Thing is, if he has the title, he gets to wrestle matches against stronger opponents. Now, of course, comes Palpatine. And look at that shit. He even has the Undertaker's video on the screens. I mean, he had that before as well, but I notice it now because he beat the Undertaker last week. The chemistry of this atmosphere is unlike that of any other. Oh yeah, whatever. Palpatine exists. Let's hope this is a good main event, and let's hope that Palpatine gets beat up in a cage.
Let's hope he breaks a leg.
If he breaks a leg, he can't climb the cage anymore.
How tragic.
Yeah, it's horrible. It would be a shame if that happened.
He wouldn't be able to fight next week.
Yeah, it would be especially horrible. When he has to fight somebody. We have some Metatron music in the background, very good. I think it was Evil in the thread who suggested that this match should end by somebody climbing out while Palpatine performs the Galactic Elbow on somebody, because that would be hilarious. I hope that's gonna happen. And I think it's a little bit sad that Fred right now gets beaten up by Palpatine.
He's just going to tire Palpatine out a bit, and then we team up on him.
That's technically what you should do, yes. But I'm not gonna pretend that the AI actually is smart enough to do that.
Best boss in Undertale?
Muffet, yeah. Pretty good boss. Pretty good music too. But I say that about every song in the soundtrack, so yeah.
If you hear a song and it's from Undertale, it's the best part of Undertale.
Well, the music's pretty good, but I'd argue that the context in which the music appears makes it even better.
That is also the best part of Undertale.
The best part of Undertale is that it's Undertale.
Exactly.
Okay, seriously, for a second here, like, this wasn't supposed to be the Undertale shilling stream, but Undertale is good, and if you haven't played it, you should probably try it for $10. Just pretend that you got banned from Essay and have to rebuy your account, only instead you have to buy Undertale and play it. It's not even a punishment. It's just...
It's that good. Just stop watching the stream, go and buy it right now.
Yeah, stop watching this fucking shit. This is horrible. Play Undertale instead. Honestly, if you leave the stream to play Undertale, I'm not even mad. Anyway, there's a match going on.
Oh, yeah.
Sans Abraham is about to climb out of the cage, but the Pyroi isn't having any of that.
Of course not, I've got to win.
Hey, Divine Coffee Binge, how can you tell that I like Undertale? That's ludicrous. I didn't say anything that would imply that I like Undertale. By the way, Divine Coffee Binge, if you haven't played Undertale, maybe play it. Unless you don't want it, that's perfectly cool, I'm not gonna force you or anything. Anyway, there's a match going on!
Hey, a match!
It's the main event, it's supposed to be exciting and stuff.
Yeah, but Undertale.
Match! Look at, Palpatine stumbling around. Oh god. Perchik slammed against the cage and... I think Palpatine's broken.
Oh no, how terrible.
And then we have some pretty romantic music. Oh my god, look at this shit. Who's gonna...
Oh no.
No! No, don't do it! Don't do it! Don't do it! Oh my god.
Well, fuck.
At least he didn't pull down Fred. That's a perfect music for that, by the way.
I guess he's gonna get a shot at reclaiming his title.
He is. As I already said, any outcome would have been fine except for Palpatine winning. Because if Palpatine wins, I can't do stuff.
Oh boy.
So, yeah, so this was the last official match, but we did decide that Ric Flair is our next big opponent. And Flamander is gonna be the first one to give it a shot. So we're gonna see that in just a little bit, in a second. Because, yeah, Ric Flair is actually pretty great, I guess. I mean, I did describe him to Rara sometime before the show in not exactly the most flattering of ways. I think what I said was is that he's famous for yelling "woo" and falling over a lot.
Yeah, pretty much.
Which is actually true, by the way. But this is wrestling, so... And wrestling sucks, by the way. But this is wrestling. And if I say something, it doesn't sound awesome, it probably means it's awesome anyway. Because wrestling is dumb. Case in point, LPFWA. And if something is dumb, it's probably good. Except wrestling. Wrestling is pretty bad. But this is good, believe me. It's. I'm not making a strong case, aren't I?
No, this is airtight.
So there's two versions of Ric Flair in this game. We are, of course, going to use the retro version. Because even though the retro version is already old, the... Not retro versions, even older. Because Ric Flair has already looked old when he wasn't old yet. It's kind of weird. It's just kind of how it is.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, sure. So, Flamander. So... What show should Ric Flair fight Flamander at? Like, it's always been WrestleMania so far. It's been WrestleMania 12 for the Undertaker, is it Undertale, oh god. And 9 for John Cena. So which WrestleMania should Ric Flair defend his title at? Not that he has the title, just... He's Ric Flair, his Ric Flair title, yeah, that's the one. Or you could just go for another pay-per-view.
One looks the coolest.
13 has fire on it.
13.
We are 30 this. Oh yeah, that's the most horribly. Oh, look at that fucking fire! Oh my god. I like that you're laughing. We're probably thinking the same thing. I hope we are. Okay, final, for real final match, because I didn't actually put this on the card, but it was supposed to be, but I didn't know who was actually gonna be the one who people are gonna vote, so there. And here comes the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. And this is Ric Flair in his younger days, and look at how old he looks. The fucking fire god. What year was this again? Was a year in which this fire.
It was the year 1873.
Well, this. It was a year in which this fire was acceptable, somehow. I could do better in paint! Well, I couldn't in paint, probably, but in some other program. I could. And yeah, Ric Flair was amazing. I just. Because I knew. Before the show, that Ric Flair was gonna be the one we're gonna fight. I just watched a couple of his promos, and he's incredibly narcissistic. It's an incredibly good character, actually. He's great. Like, there's this part where he just takes off his shoe, holds in the camera, and says, "This shoe costs more than your fucking house." Only didn't say fuck because that was the old times when people didn't swear on TV. And he constantly just, you know, in other promos, just randomly took off part of his clothing for some reason. Nobody knows why. And then he did some, like, his signature strut. And yeah, this is, by the way, Flamander's 2-title entrance. And he comes into music from Undertale, surprise.
Wait, so, if Flamander loses, what happens to Black's title?
Wow, that's a good question.
John Cena gets it.
No. Ric Flair gets it. Oh god. I didn't think of this beforehand. I didn't think this through. Oh my god.
Oh no.
If Ric Flair wins, he's gonna have Black's title. And we have to reclaim it.
Well, that would separate it from.
Yeah, that's a good part about it. yeah. Anyway. I hope this can be a squash match, though. I'm not gonna say who I'm rooting for, though. I mean, I like.
Giant letters.
I would like to at least see the worm. A few times. Not just once. Like.
There's 5 or 6.
Well, we saw it twice against John Cena, that was amazing. So yeah, Ric Flair versus Flamander. I have no idea how Ric Flair performs in this game. So this could either be a very embarrassing match for him, or it could be the beginning of something wonderful. Either way, it's gonna be a match that's happening. Oh, yeah, it looks like Ric Flair is gonna get the shit punched out of him. In case somebody doesn't know, which I assume is some people, Ric Flair kind of had this signature thing where he'd get the shit beat out of him, then he'd just kind of nonchalantly walk around for a second or so before he falls down. Of course, he'd also win a lot of matches. After all, he was a 14-time champion. But that was a thing he did a lot. He also yelled, "Woo!" a lot.
Woo!
Like, even in the middle of sentences, like, if he cuts promos, he'll just say something, then go, "Woo!" and then continue with his promo. It's hilarious. Like, as I said, I actually watched promos of his before this show started, just, you know, to remind myself who Ric Flair is, because I don't actually watch wrestling, is the thing. But I did see back in the day a few matches of Ric Flair.
WWE 2K16 doesn't have create a campaign.
Yes. And neither does WWE 2K15, otherwise it would be using that. It's sad, really. They removed the features that I care about. Like, the only feature I care about. I don't play this game, actually, is the thing. I did not purchase to get this game to play it, as dumb as that sounds. I purchased it specifically to do this. Which is probably the most idiotic thing I did my entire life. I'm waiting for people to say, "No, this is great," but whatever.
"No, this is great."
Thank you.
Or whatever.
Good. I didn't see that coming, even though I... yeah. That was a weird move. It looked like it should hurt Flamander and not Ric Flair. And I don't have a drinking problem. What are you talking about? I'm perfectly sober. I'm sober right now, is the problem.
My god.
I powered in drinks a couple times, but they were, just, you know, some energy drink I had. Not anything alcoholic. Oh wait, of course it was alcohol this entire time. I'm completely shit-faced. That's a sweet song in the background right now. Let me turn it up a bit.
Oh yeah, this is a great one.
Yeah, it is. We say this about every song, come on.
Well, it's like every boss song that comes up. Oh, this is a good song.
Oh yeah. It really is, though. Well, yeah, 2K14 doesn't have my career mode, but as I said, I didn't buy this game to play it. I just bought it to watch AI matches and stream them. Which, again, is completely idiotic. I spent money on this. Can you believe that? Specifically for this. I didn't buy this game for anything but this. Just, you know, think about that for a second. And I also didn't buy the previous game for anything but this. The only reason I played either of them was to be able to know the controls in case I have to play it at some point. But look at that, Ric Flair is getting beaten. Well, 2K14 doesn't have online gaming anymore, yeah, because the servers got shut down by the end of last month.
How terrible.
Doesn't matter anymore.
It would matter if more people would submit their own characters instead of having me make them, but thankfully I got Action Shakespeare's female character in time.
Oh, good.
It's a skeleton.
Yeah.
It's great. I like it. It's way better than Bob Marley. And it's the worm.
Come on.
It's time.
It's time.
It's the worm.
And for the first time, the worm did not get interrupted in chat. And holy shit!
Oh.
What? What? Whoa!
The worm is invincible! Okay.
This is why he is LPFWA champion!
I can't wait for Frederick Hope's rematch next week now. Because Flemma just proved that he's probably actually good. Probably.
I mean, sure, he lost to John Cena, but...
Oh, come on, John Cena's... John Cena. And John Cena only lost because he got put through a flaming table.
Hey, now, come on.
Well, okay, I'm not trying to downplay Chumpei's victory. It's still pretty great. He probably would have won anyway because he did pretty good. But I'm just gonna say that John Cena can do anything. He can recover from any pin unless he gets put through a flaming table.
To be fair, most people can't really survive being put through a flaming table.
I got that fucking fire.
I knew you were gonna say that.
I knew you knew I was gonna say that. I knew. Copyright 1997. All rights reserved. Yes, we have 1997 right now, guys.
Time travel.
It's amazing.
Sims magic.
Sims magic. By the way, I keep meaning to include Sims Magic in more matches, but why aren't I? I should do that. But this has been the final match of this evening. We've seen the worms, so I am pretty sure we're all gonna leave satisfied. And,
I'm not satisfied. I'm not getting the title shot next week.
Maybe you'll get one eventually, who knows. But I know what you're all gonna say, but I'm gonna ask anyway. Are there any more words from you guys that you want to, you know, bestow on our audience? Play Undertale.
Play Undertale.
Play Undertale.
Okay, that's good enough.